الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد إن شاء الله تعالى Today we're going to speak about the third marhala, the third stage that every single one of us will go through. We spoke about daru dunya, this world. And we also spoke about darul barzakh, which is the grave and matters related to that. And the way that the people are in their qubur, in their graves. Today, inshaAllah ta'ala, I'm going to speak about Darul Akhirah, the Day of Judgment. The Day of Judgment is called Yawmul Akhirah. And the scholars, they say the reason why it was called Yawmul Akhirah is because it's a day, there is no day after it. It's your final stage. The last ayah that came down in the Quran, Allah Azza wa Jalla, He said, وَاتَّقُوا يَوْمًا تُرْجَعُونَ فِيهِ إِلَى اللَّهِ ثُمَّ تُوَفَّى كُلُّ نَفْسٍ مَّا كَسَبَتْ وَهُمْ لَا يُظْلَمُونَ. Allah Azza wa Jalla, He said, وَاتَّقُوا, be conscious of Allah Azza wa Jalla, have taqwa. It's the last ayah in the Quran. No ayah came down after this. Allah says, وَاتَّقُوا, have taqwa of Allah Azza wa Jalla. Of what? Of a day that you're going to all return back to Allah Azza wa Jalla. And every single person's nafs is going to be taken from him. And the way that you're going to be taken, and the way that you're going to be accounted, is in accordance to what? مَا كَسَبَتْ, that which you have put forward. Allah then says, subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَهُمْ لَا يُظْلَمُونَ, no one will be oppressed that day. Allah Azza wa Jalla, when it came to the Akhirah, He made its affairs something very big. Allah Azza wa Jalla, He says in the Quran, وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا يَوْمُ الدِّينِ, what do you really know about the Day of Judgment? And then Allah says, ثُمَّ مَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا يَوْمُ الدِّينِ, do you really know the Day of Judgment? Do you really understand what it is? Two times, Allah repeats the same question. Do you actually know the Day of Judgment? And then Allah says, ثُمَّ مَا أَدْرَكَ مَا يَوْمُ الدِّينِ, do you actually really know what that day is? And then Allah summarized it in one ayah. What did He say? يَوْمَ لَا تَمْلِكُ نَفْسٌ لِنَفْسٍ شَيْئًا, no one can help you that day. No individual can support you. No one can aid you. وَالْأَمْرُ يَوْمَئِذٍ لِلَّهِ, all of the matters is all in the hands of Allah Azza wa Jalla. Your parents are going to leave you. Your loved ones, the ones that you today, because of them you disobey Allah, they're going to walk away from you. No one's going to be there to aid you. The affairs is in Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala's hand. وَالْأَمْرُ يَوْمَئِذٍ لِلَّهِ, the smart person, the clever individual, is the one that realizes pleasing Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala should be his first priority. Pleasing those you think are loved to you today, they're not going to help you that day. يَوْمَ لَا تَمْلِكُ نَفْسٌ لِنَفْسٍ شَيْئًا, it can be a king, it can be a ruler, it can be whatever, that day they can do nothing for you. Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, as I said, He spoke about the Akhirah as something big. Allah says in the Quran, Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, He said, إِنَّ هَؤُلَاءِ يُحِبُّونَ الْعَاجِلَةِ وَيَذَرُونَ وَرَاءَهُمْ يَوْمًا ثَقِيلًا. Allah referred to the Day of Judgment as what? يَوْمًا ثَقِيلًا, a heavy day. Imagine Allah, Rabbul Alameen, is referring to that day, the Day of Judgment, as what? يَوْمٌ ثَقِيلٌ, a heavy day. Allah also says in another ayah, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ اتَّقُوا رَبَّكُمْ إِنَّ زَلْزَلَةَ السَّاعَةِ شَيْءٌ عَظِيمٌ. Allah referred to it here as what? A great day. Let's ponder on this ayah. يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ اتَّقُوا رَبَّكُمْ. Those of you who believe in Allah Azza wa Jalla, I mean all mankind, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ, people, اتَّقُوا رَبَّكُمْ, have taqwa of Allah Azza wa Jalla. Have what? Have taqwa of Allah Azza wa Jalla. Allah then says, إِنَّ زَلْزَلَةَ السَّاعَةِ شَيْءٌ عَظِيمٌ. The earthquake that's going to happen, Allah Azza wa Jalla, He says, it's a big thing. It's not a light matter. إِنَّ زَلْزَلَةَ, the earthquake is what? إِنَّ زَلْزَلَةَ السَّاعَةِ شَيْءٌ عَظِيمٌ. The earthquake is something humongous, something big, extraordinary. How is it big? This earth today, which is this strong, Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala will make it move. The mountains that are on it, Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, He told us that He's going to uproot it, take the mountains from the earth, and Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala is going to scatter it into the sky, and it will become like dust. Allah says, فَإِذَا نُفِخَ فِي الصُّورِ نَفْخَةٌ وَاحِدَةٌ وَحُمِلَتِ الْأَرْضُ وَالْجِبَالُ فَدُكَّتَا دَكَّةً وَاحِدَةً فَيَوْمَئِذٍ وَقَعَتِ الْوَاقِعَةِ وَانْشَقَّتِ السَّمَاءِ. The sama is going to crack. And Allah referred to the sama as what? Wahiya, flimsy. The sama that you can see today, that's strong, that doesn't need a pillar to hold it, that day it will become what? It will be flimsy. And Allah is going to bring cracks into that sama. And guess who's going to descend from it? وَيَحْمِلُ عَرْشَ رَبِّكَ يَوْمَئِذٍ ثَمَانِيَةً. Eight are carrying your Lord. Eight angels, eight this. No one knows what these eight are. Allahu A'lam. Only Allah knows. But eight are carrying your Lord that day. وَالْمَلَكُ عَلَىٰ أَرْجَائِهَا. When the sky is cracked, the angels are on the sides and the corners of the sama. وَيَحْمِلُ عَرْشَ رَبِّكَ يَوْمَئِذٍ ثَمَانِيَةً. Allah says, subhanahu wa ta'ala, يَوْمَئِذٍ تُعْرَضُونَ لَا تَخْفَى مِكُمْ خَافِيَةً. That day, the people's actions will be presented to them. You're going to know what you really are. In another ayah, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He says, إِذَا السَّمَاءُ فَطَرَتْ وَإِذَا الْكَوَاكِبُ انْتَثَرَتْ وَإِذَا الْبِحَارُ فُجِّرَتْ وَإِذَا الْقُبُورُ بُعْثِرَتْ عَلِمَتْ نَفْسٌ مَا قَدَّمَتْ وَأَخَّرَتْ. The sky will be split open. The stars that you see in the sky will all scatter. The oceans that you see, they're all open together. There's no sea, river, lake. All of it becomes one. Allah then says, عَلِمَتْ نَفْسٌ مَا قَدَّمَتْ وَأَخَّرَتْ. Everyone's going to know that day what they have put forward. Everyone, reality will hit them. Let's go back to the ayah where Allah says, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ اتَّقُوا رَبَّكُمْ إِنَّ زَلْزَلَةَ السَّاعَةِ شَيْءٌ عَظِيمٌ يَوْمَ تَرَوْنَهَا تَجْهَلُ كُلُّ مُرْضِعَةٍ عَمَّا أَرْضَعَتْ. A mother that day, the child that she was breastfeeding, she will throw that child. A mother's going to throw her child. It's the same mother who focuses on when she breastfeeds her child. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, one day he was with his companions and he saw a woman looking for her child, and every single time she saw a child, she grabbed the child and she breastfed. She would look and she would realize this is not her child. She would throw it and she would grab another child and she would look, realize it's not her child, and she would throw it. And then the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to the companions, do you think this mother would ever throw her child into the fire? The Sahabas, they said, no, Messenger of Allah. He said, Allah is more merciful to His creation than this mother towards her child. But that mother, what was she doing? She was looking for her child, she can't find it. So whichever child she saw, she thought it was her child, she wants to breastfeed it. That same mother, that day will throw her child. Also, the mother who is pregnant, she will give birth to the child إِنَّ زَلْزَلَةَ السَّاعَةِ شَيْءٌ عَظِيمٌ يَوْمَ تَرَوْنَهَا تَذْهَلُ كُلُّ مُرْضِعَةٍ عَمَّا أَرْضَعَتْ وَتَضَعُ كُلُّ ذَاتِ حَمْلٍ حَمْلَهَا. And the mother will give birth to her child, and guess what? As soon as she gives birth, she's going to walk. She's not going to lie down, and she's not going to go through pain, and she's not, nothing, the mind is gone. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He says, وَتَرَى النَّاسَ السُّكَارَى. That day you'll see the people like they are drunk. وَمَا هُمْ بِسُكَارَى. They're not drunk from drugs that they took or alcohol that they had. That's not what's taken their mind. وَتَرَى النَّاسَ السُّكَارَى وَمَا هُمْ بِسُكَارَى وَلَكِنَّ عَذَابَ اللَّهِ شَدِيدٌ. But the reality is, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's punishment is severe. It's the adab of Allah which is making them like this. It is the punishment of Allah that they know that's making them like this. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, one day he read an ayah from Surah إِذَا زُلْزِلَةِ الْأَرْضُ زِلْزَالَهَا. Allah recited, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, recited the ayah إِذَا زُلْزِلَةِ الْأَرْضُ زِلْزَالَهَا وَأَخْرَجَتِ الْأَرْضُ أَثْقَالَهَا وَقَالَ الْإِنسَانُ مَا لَهَا يَوْمَئِذٍ تُحَدِّثُ أَخْبَارَهَا. The day when the earthquake happens, إِذَا زُلْزِلَةِ الْأَرْضُ زِلْزَالَهَا وَأَخْرَجَتِ الْأَرْضُ أَثْقَالَهَا, and the earth spits out what was inside it. The people will be spat out, the earth will spit it out. And the person, what would they say? وَقَالَ الْإِنسَانُ مَا لَهَا. The person will say, what is for me? What is it for me today? Allah then says, يَوْمَئِذٍ تُحَدِّثُ أَخْبَارَهَا. That day, it will tell its news. Al-Imam al-Tirmidhi narrated in his Sunan min Hadith Abi Hurairah that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to his companions, أَتَدْرُونَ مَا أَخْبَارُهَا. Do you know what the news that will be told that day? Do you know what it is? The Sahabas, they said, اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ أَعْلَمُ. Allah and His Messenger know. Only Allah and His Messenger know. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said that the akhbar, the news that this, that will be given that day is, this earth will talk. This earth is going to talk. And this earth is going to inform every single thing that was done on it. The earth will say, you did this on me, this particular day. The earth is going to talk, and it's going to witness against you. It's a day, brothers, not the earth only is going to witness against you, but your own limbs are going to witness against you. Allah says, subhanahu wa ta'ala, الْيَوْمَ نَخْتِمُ عَلَىٰ أَفْوَاهِمْ وَتُكَلِّمُنَا أَيْدِيهِمْ وَتَشْهَدُ أَرْجُلُهُمْ بِمَا كَانُوا يَكْسِبُونَ. This day is a day where Allah tabarak wa ta'ala will what? He will silence your mouth. He will mute your mouth. Your mouth cannot talk anymore. And the thing that's going to witness against you is what? الْيَوْمَ نَخْتِمُ عَلَىٰ أَفْوَاهِهِمْ وَتُكَلِّمُنَا أَيْدِيهِمْ. Their hands are going to talk. وَتَشْهَدُ أَرْجُلُهُمْ بِمَا كَانُوا يَكْسِبُونَ. His mouth is going to be silenced. The hands are going to talk, and the legs are going to be like, yes. Yes, the hands have told the truth. And the person will then look at his palms, and he will look at his legs. And he will say to the palms, why are you confessing? Why are you exposing me for? Why are you getting me in trouble? The mouth will say, I wanted to save you. And here you are exposing me. And then the hand and the legs will say, أَنْطَقَنَ اللَّهُ الَّذِي أَنْطَقَ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ. Allah is the one who made us speak today, the one who makes everything speak. We had no other way out of it. It is a day like that, that particular day that's awaiting each and every one of us. But Allah told us, subhanahu wa ta'ala, at the beginning of the ayah, where things are going wrong. And that is what Allah says in two ayahs that I mentioned. وَاتَّقُوا يَوْمًا تُرْجَعُونَ فِيهِ إِلَى اللَّهِ يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ اتَّقُوا رَبَّكُمْ إِنَّ زَلْزَلَةَ السَّاعَةِ شَيْءٌ عَظِيمٌ. Taqwa. Before Allah told us about the ahwal of the Day of Judgment, what did He tell us, subhanahu wa ta'ala? He told us, subhanahu wa ta'ala, to come with taqwa, to be conscious of Allah Azza wa Jalla. Ali ibn Abi Talib, he said, taqwa is al-khawfu min al-jaleel, is to fear Allah Azza wa Jalla. Taqwa means al-khawf min al-jalil is to really fear Allah Azza wa Jalla. Wal-amalu bit-tanzeel, it's to implement the Quran and live by the Quran and the Sunnah. Wal-ridha bil-qaleel, to be happy with the little Allah has given you subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa-isti'dadu li-yawm al-rahil, to prepare for the day of judgment. That's taqwa. Four things. Al-khawf min al-jalil, be scared of Allah Azza wa Jalla. والعمل بالتنزيل, implement the Quran and the Sunnah. والرضا بالقليل, be happy with the little Allah has given you. Why do you have to get excited in wanting to get more? The halal that you have, even if it's little, that is better for you than what? Than the haram in large quantity that you're trying to gather and bring together. Just the other day, I was reading the kitab Tartib al-Idariyah, written by Muhammad Abdul Hayy al-Kattani. And this book is very beneficial. It talks about how the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam administrated Medina and how he controlled things. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his skill of leadership. It's an amazing book, two volumes. As I was reading this book, I stood over the biography of the noble Imam Umar ibn Abdul Aziz. Umar ibn Abdul Aziz rahimahullah, just to show you that how pleased he was with the little Allah gave him subhanahu wa ta'ala. Umar ibn Abdul Aziz, as you all know, once upon a time he governed the world, the Muslim world. It was said few could say this. Umar ibn Abdul Aziz and Harun al-Rashid and others, that they had the ability to speak to the cloud and say to the cloud, rain over there or rain over there. For verily what will come back to me is whatever fruits that come from the rain. Because if that cloud goes and it rains on the lands of the Muslim, then zakat will be taken from them. And if it was the non-Muslims, jizya will be taken from them. Meaning, he could allow the cloud to go anywhere, it will still come back to him. How large his kingdom was. Umar ibn Abdul Aziz. It reached a point, his time, rahimahullah, that they couldn't find anyone to give sadaqah to. People were begged to take sadaqah and they would say no. Umar ibn Abdul Aziz's time. And the treasures of Baytul Mal al-Muslimin was full of gold and diamonds hanging. And even then when he would come to his house, he once upon a time came to Fatima bint Qais, Fatima bint Abdul Aziz. And he said to her, Fatima, I like anab, grapes. Can you find me some grapes? And she said, we don't have it. And he said, okay, no problem. I'll be patient. And she said to him, how is it fair that you govern the Muslims today and we're probably one of the poorest people? The people that we govern have more than us. And then he said, and she said to him, the gold and the silvers that are in the Baytul Mal al-Muslimin that are hanging, is there nothing that we can take from this? Fatima, you have to keep in mind, her father, Abdul Malik ibn Marwan, was a leader. Her brothers, both of them were leaders, and her husband is a leader. She's from a family of leadership, and she's accepting this lifestyle as well. Umar ibn Abdul Aziz was excessively wealthy before he became a leader. And when he became a leader, he became poor. But this is what I want from the story. He said to his wife, he responded to her, he said, I prefer to be patient from the chains that are hanging in the Baytul Mal al-Muslimin. I prefer to be patient from it and abandon and avoid it than the chains of Jahannam, the Day of Judgment. Umar ibn Abdul Aziz left very little money for his children. The scholars, they differ how much he left. Ala kulli hal, he left very little. A lot of it was paid towards his shrouding and the washing of his body. And his children, he left very little for them. But his cousin, Hisham, who left for his children, each one thousands of dinar is made out of gold. And Umar ibn Abdul Aziz left what? Very little for his children. The narrator of the story said, I saw with my two eyes Hisham's children reach a point in poverty where they were begging the people and people were gathering money for them. And I saw Umar ibn Abdul Aziz's children given each day 100 camels. Sadaqah. I saw that take place. Al-rida bil-qaleel. Because he left with his children little but halal. He was pleased with that little halal and that brought contentment for him. Because he had what? At-taqwa. And one of the last ayah that he recited before he died was the ayah, تِلْكَ الدَّارُ الْآخِرَةِ نَجْعَلُهَا لِلَّذِينَ لَا يُرِيدُونَ عُلُوًا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَلَا فَسَادًا وَالْعَاقِبَةُ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. That the day of judgment is for the people who are pious. The people who don't want to be very high on this earth. They don't want to be big. They don't want to be known. They're just simple people. And then Allah says, وَالْعَاقِبَةُ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. And the final ending is for the righteous people. Brothers, if you truly believe in this day, and wallahi the day of judgment is something you believe in, and you came with one of the articles of Iman, the day of judgment should be something you believe it's very close, it's not far. Number one, you believe it's something very close and it's not far. Allah says in the Quran, اِقْتَرَبَتِ السَّاعَةِ وَانْشَقَّ الْقَمَرِ. Allah says also, اِقْتَرَبَ لِلنَّاسِ حِسَابُهُمْ وَهُمْ فِي غَفْلَةٍ مُعْرِضُونَ. Allah says, أَتَى أَمْرُ اللَّهِ فَلَا تَسْتَعَجِلُوهُ. Allah says, إِنَّهُمْ يَرَوْنَهُ بَعِيدًا وَنَرَاهُ قَرِيبًا. Allah also says, أَزِفَتِ الْآزِفَةِ لَيْسَ لَهَا مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ كَاشِفَةً. All of those ayat, Allah is telling us that the day of judgment is close. It's not something far. إِنَّهُمْ يَرَوْنَهُ بَعِيدًا. You're the one who sees it to be far. But Allah sees it to be something very close. Bukhari and Muslim both narrated that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said, بُعِذْتُ أَنَا وَالسَّاعَةُ كَهَاتَيْنِ. Me and the hour were brought out like this. فَقَارَنَ بَيْنَ السَّبَّابَةِ وَالْوُسْطَى. The Prophet stuck his two fingers like this. He said, the hour and me are like this. Some narrations, like the famous hadith of Abi Umamah al-Bahili in Sahih Muslim, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentioned, Amma Sunan ibn Majah, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentioned, he said, I hope to meet my brother Isa ibn Maryam. And if I don't, whichever of you meet Isa ibn Maryam, let him convey my salams onto him. In other words, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam believed everything was close. If you believe in the day of judgment, don't live a life that you believe the day of judgment is far and it's not going to take place anytime soon. Wallahi, it's closer to you than your shoelaces. Number two, to always remember it and never forget it. That the akhirah is always on your mind. Allah says in the Quran, فَالْيَوْمَ نَنْسَاكُمْ كَمَا نَسِيتُمْ لِقَاءَ يَوْمِكُمْ هَذَا. Allah says, today we will forsake you the way that you forgot the day of judgment. Don't forget the day of judgment. Let it always be on your mind. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يُضِلُّونَ عَن سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ لَهُمْ عَذَابٌ شَدِيدٌ بِمَا نَسُوا يَوْمَ الْحِسَابِ. Don't forget it. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله ولتنظر نفس ما قدمت لغد واتقوا الله إن الله خبير بما تعملون. Prepare for that day, work for it. ولا تكونوا كالذين نسوا الله فأنساهم أنفسهم. Don't be like those who forgot Allah and Allah forgot them. أمر الله تبارك وتعالى abandon them. Allah what? Abandon them. To always remember the day of judgment and keep it in your mind. Consistently and continuously remember it. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, شَيَّبَتْنِي هُودٌ وَأَخَوَاتُهَا. Surah Hud, and its sisters have made my beard what? It made my beard white. Always remember it. To place the akhirah and the affairs of the akhirah in front of your eyes. Also, to take provision for it. If you truly believe in the day of judgment, take provision for it. Allah says in the Quran, وَتَزَوَّدُوا فَإِنَّ خَيْرَ الزَّادِ التَّقْوَى. Take provision. For verily, the best provision to take that day is what? Taqwa. The situation of many of us today, as the poet said, is we're absent from even working on our deeds and our actions. And the reason for that is we don't realize the great power and the great weight that the Day of Judgment holds. Every single day that comes by in your life, brothers and sisters, every single day, every day that go by, ask yourself two questions. What more beneficial knowledge have I gained? And what righteous actions have I increased? Every day, your actions and your knowledge is growing. You're not like how you grow. You increase in your knowledge, and you also increase in your what? Every day. Before you go to sleep, ask yourself this question. That's the essence of taqwa. A poet said, he said, مَثِّلْ وُقُوفِكَ يَوْمَ الْعَرْضِ عُرْيَانًا. Place yourself the day when you're going to stand in front of Allah naked, you're wearing nothing. The poet, he said, مَثِّلْ وُقُوفِكَ يَوْمَ الْعَرْضِ عُرْيَانًا مُسْتَوْحِشٌ أَمَا مُسْتَوْحِشًا قَلِقَ الْأَحْشَاءَ حَيْرَانًا. That day you're shocked. You're in a place where you haven't ever seen these type of creation. Always place this in your mind. وَالنَّارُ تَلْهَبْ مِنْ غَيْظٍ وَمِنْ حَلَقٍ. The hellfire that day is roaring, it's making a great sound. عَلَى الْعُصَاتِ وَرَبُّ الْعَرْشِ غَضْبَانًا. To who like in the sinners? And Allah that day is angry, and anger, He's never become angry. اِقْرَأْ كِتَابَكَ يَا عَبْدَ اللَّهِ عَلَى مَهَلٍ فَهَلْ تَرَى فِيهِ حَرْفًا غَيْرَ مَا كَانَ. And then it will be said to you, slave, read your book. اِقْرَأْ كِتَابَكَ كَفَى بِنَفْسِكَ الْيَوْمَ عَلَيْكَ حَسِيبًا. Read your book. It's enough for you today, something to busy yourself with. And when you read your book, everything that's in there is what you really did. The poet, he then said, لَمَّا قَرَأْتَ وَلَمْ تُنْكِرْ قِرَاءَتَهُ إِقْرَارَ مَنْ عَرَفَ الْأَشْيَاءَ عِرْفَانًا. You read the book, and all you can do is just nod to it and say, yes, wallahi, I did do this. I did say this. I did act in this way. Remember, نَادَ الْجَلِيلُ خُذُوهُ يَا مَلَائِكَتِي. Allah will call the angels, and He would say to the angels, grab this person and take him. وَمْضُوا بِعَبْدٍ أَصَى لِلنَّارِ عَطْشَانًا. Give him to the hellfire that's thirsty, that would want to eat him. وَالْمُجْرِمُونَ غَدًا فِي النَّارِ يَلْتَهِبُوا وَالْمُؤْمِنُونَ فِي جَنَّةِ الْخُلْدِ سُكَانًا. The criminals are going to be thrown into the hellfire, and it will destroy them. And the believers, they are in Jannah, the place that they want. Brothers, that day is very big. أَلَا يَظُنُّ أُولَٰئِكَ أَنَّهُمْ مَبْعُوثُونَ لِيَوْمٍ عَظِيمٍ. It's a big day. It's not a light day. It's a humongous day. And you're either one of two. Wallahi, you're not a third. You're either فَرِيقٌ فِي الْجَنَّةِ وَفَرِيقٌ فِي السَّعِيرِ. You're either from the people of the hellfire, or you're from the people of Jannah. May Allah make us from the people of... Fudayl ibn Iyad one day saw a man. Fudayl ibn Iyad, he saw a man. He said, كَمْ مَضَى مِنْ عُمْرِكَ. How many years have you lived? How old are you? The man said, سِتُّونَ عَامًا. I'm 60. I'm 60 years of age. Fudayl then said, مُنْذُ سِتِّينَ سَنَةً. For 60 years, وَأَنْتَ تَسِيرُ إِلَى اللَّهِ. And you were going to Allah. يُوشِكُ أَنْ تَصِلْ. Soon you're going to reach Him. He said, I'm 60. And he said, for 60 years you've been getting closer to Allah. Soon you're going to get to Him. The man said, إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. Fudayl ibn Iyad then said to him, أَتَعْرِفُ تَفْسِيرَهُ. Do you know what you're saying? Do you know the meaning to it? The man said, no. Fudayl then said, مَنْ عَلِمَ. Anyone who knows, أَنَّ لَهُ أَنَّهُ لِلَّهِ عَبْدٌ. Anyone who knows that he is a slave to Allah Azza wa Jalla. وَأَنَّهُ إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُ. And he knows that he's going to back to Allah. فَلْيَعْلَمْ. Let him know. أَنَّهُ مَوْقُوفٌ. That he's going to stand in front of him. وَمَنْ عَلِمَ. And anyone who knows. أَنَّهُ مَوْقُوفٌ. Anyone who knows that he's going to stand in front of Allah. فَلْيَعْلَمْ Let him know أَنَّهُ مَسْؤُولٌ That he's going to be interrogated and questioned. وَمَنْ عَلِمَ And anyone who knows that he's going to be interrogated and questioned, فَلْيُعِدَّ لِسْتُؤَالِ جَوَابًا Let him prepare the answers for that questions. Let him prepare the answers for those questions. Any one of you who've oppressed anybody or who's wronged them, remember أَنَّكَ رَاجِعٌ إِلَى اللَّهِ You're going to go back to Allah. وَمَوْقُوفٌ بَيْنَ يَدَيِ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى And you'll be stood in front of him. لَيْسَ بَيْنَكَ وَبَيْنَ اللَّهِ تُرْجُمَانِ There's no translator between you and Allah. Oh, you parents who forsaked your child and you didn't do the responsibilities on you, remember أَنَّكَ رَاجِعٌ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَمَوْقُوفٌ بَيْنَ يَدَيِ That you're going to go back to Allah and that you're going to be interrogated and questioned. And though the ones who have taken haram and taken riba, اعلم أنك راجع إلى الله Know that you're going to go back to Allah وموقوف بين يديه And that you're going to stand in front of him أيها الزاني Oh you who have committed zina Thought that you can get away with it اعلم أنك راجع إلى الله Know that you're going to go back to Allah And Allah is going to question you سبحانه وتعالى The one who believes in the day of judgment He knows that he has to prepare for it And he has to do righteous deeds. One of the things that we have to do, brothers, about the Day of Judgment is be scared about it. This is the fifth point, which is to be scared of the Day of Judgment. Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, He says in the Quran, Ya ayyuha an-nas, uttaqu rabbakum wakhshaw yawma. Have khashya of a day. Yawma la tajzi walidun. A day when a parent cannot reward their child. And a child cannot reward his parents. Allah told us to be scared, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Look, Allah said about the believers, إِنَّمَا نُطْعِمُكُمْ لِوَجْهِ اللَّهِ لَا نُرِيدُ مِكُمْ جَزَاءً وَلَا شُكُورًا إِنَّا نَخَافُ مِنْ رَبِّنَا يَوْمًا عَبُوسًا قَمْطَرِيرًا فَوَقَاهُمُ اللَّهُ شَرَّ ذَلِكَ الْيَوْمِ وَلَقَّاهُمْ نَظَرَةً وَسُرُورًا They feed, they give those in need. And when they give, You know what they say? إِنَّا نَخَافُ مِنْ رَبِّنَا يَوْمًا We fear Allah the day. Meaning the day of judgment. That day, brothers, is a day when nobody can speak except when Allah gives them permission. Allah says in the Quran, يَوْمَئِذٍ يَتَّبِعُونَ الدَّاعِيَ لَا عِوَجَ لَهُ وخشعت الأصوات للرحمن فلا تسمع إلا همسا Everyone's just going to follow the caller. The caller is going to say, come, go this way, go this way. And people are going to follow. Allah then says, سبحانه وتعالى وخشعت الأصوات The voices that day, they're quiet. No one's talking. Everybody's quiet that day. All you can hear is footsteps. People's movements, that's it. No one's talking, no one's saying anything, no one's talking to anybody. Everyone that day is scared. Allah told us in the Day of Judgment, the people of Jannah are going to meet each other. Allah says, وَأَقْبَلَ بَعْضُهُمْ عَلَى بَعْضٍ يَتَسَأَلُونَ They're going to talk to each other. They're going to say to each other, how did you end up in Jannah? What brought you to Jannah? How did you make it here? They're talking, people of Jannah. And Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, He said that they say to each other, إِنَّا كُنَّا مِنْ قَبْلُ فِي أَهْلِنَا مُشْفِقِينَ When we were with our families, we were scared. مُشْفِقِينَ أي خائفين. We were scared. فَمَنَّ اللَّهُ عَلَيْنَا وَوَقَانَ عَذَابَ السَّمُومِ And because of that, Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, what did He do? He protected us from the hellfire. We were scared. When we were with our family, we were watching what we were saying. We were watching what we were doing. Those five that I mentioned, are what you have to come with if you truly believe in the Day of Judgment. If it's a great day for you. If you truly believe in that day. I ask Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala that He makes us a people who come with khashya, taqwa for that day. And that Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, He makes us Those which He said, تِلْكَ الْجَنَّةُ الَّتِي نُورِثُ مِنْ عِبَادِنَا مَنْ كَانَ تَقِيًّا The ones who are going to inherit Jannah are the people who came with taqwa. anything, brothers, in this world that you look at and you magnify it and you make it big, wallahi, it's really nothing big. What really is big is this day. The day Allah referred to as big. I mentioned three times Allah made it big. He said, أَلَا يَظُنُّ أُولَٰئِكَ أَنَّهُمْ مَبْعُوثُونَ لِيَوْمٍ عَظِيمٍ. Allah referred to it as يَوْمٌ عَظِيمٌ. Allah referred to it as what? إِنَّ هَؤُلَاءِ يُحِبُّونَ الْعَاجِلَةَ وَيَذَرُونَ وَرَاهُمْ يَوْمًا ثَقِيلًا. Allah referred to it as شديد. يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ اتَّقُوا رَبَّكُمْ إِنَّ زَلْزَلَةَ السَّاعَةِ شَيْءٌ عَظِيمٌ. Those are the three characteristics Allah gave it, subhanahu wa ta'ala. شديد, Allah referred to it as, and Allah referred to it as what? عظيم. إن زلزلة الساعة شيء عظيم. يوم ترونها تذهل كل مرضعة عما أرضعت وتضع كل ذات حمل حملها وترى الناس سكارى وما هم بسكارى ولكن عذاب الله شديد. That is شديد. The hellfire that day has 70,000 ropes dangling from it. As the Prophet said, لها سبعون ألف زمام. It has 70,000 ropes. لكل زمام. Each rope, 70,000 angels are pinning it down. Jahannam. That day will go out of control. And who is it going to take? The usat, the criminals, the ones who went against Allah's command, subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet told us, alayhi salatu wasalam, أي لحم نبتت على الحرام فالنار به أولى. أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام. Any body, any flesh that was fed upon haram, the hellfire has rights that day. It recognizes you from everybody else. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He says, إِذَا رَأَتْهُم مِّن مَكَانٍ بَعِيدٍ سَمِعُوا لَهَا تَغَيُّضًا وَزَفِيرًا. That when the hellfire that day sees them from far, it makes a roaring sound. It roars, it makes a big noise, Jahannam. Because it knows its people. The believer looks unique. He has signs to recognize him. The criminal, the wrongdoer, that day he has signs to be recognized. Brothers, wallahi, fear Allah Azza wa Jalla today. And be conscious of Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you want to be saved that day, wallahi, no one's going to save you except your actions. If you think that day someone is going to make you get out of that problem, wallahi, it won't be. لا حول لنا ولا قوة. We have no strength, we have no ability except Allah Azza wa Jalla. Please Him now. And His mercy and His forgiveness now. So when you come the day of judgment, Allah will take you to Jannah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me, a shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. Allahumma arina al-haqqa haqqan warzuqna ittiba'ah wa arina al-batila batilan warzuqna ijtinaba. Rabbana la tu'akhidna in nasina wa akhta'na. Rabbana la taj'ali dunya akbar hammina wa la mablagha ilmina wa la tusallit alayna bidhunubina man la yakhafuka fina wa la yarhamuna. رب آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها أنت وليها ومولاها ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار.